In the heart of Rio de Janeiro beats a rhythm that defies the odds and challenges the status quo. It's the story of Mc Neguinho, a tale of resilience, passion, and the relentless pursuit of dreams against all odds. But who is Mc Neguinho, and what makes his story so extraordinary? Join us on an emotional roller coaster as we delve into the depths of his journey, uncovering the highs, the lows, and everything in between. The birth of a dreamer. In the labyrinthine streets of Rio de Janeiro's favelas, where poverty and strife were the norm, Mc Neguinho's story began. Born into a world where survival often took precedence over dreams, he was raised amidst the chaos and vibrancy of the community. But even in the face of adversity, there was a spark within him, a flicker of hope that refused to be extinguished. From an early age, Mc Neguinho was drawn to the hypnotic rhythms of the streets, the melodic cadence that echoed through the alleyways like a siren song. It was here, amidst the hustle and bustle of everyday life, that he discovered his passion for music. With each passing day, he would immerse himself in the rich tapestry of sounds that surrounded him, absorbing the stories of struggle and triumph that permeated the air. But as he grew older, Mc Neguinho began to realize that music was more than just a hobby. It was his ticket out of the favela, his chance to break free from the cycle of poverty that had ensnared so many others. With determination burning in his veins, he set out to turn his dreams into reality, forging a path towards a brighter future against all odds. Dancing with destiny. Armed with nothing but a microphone and a dream, Mc Neguinho embarked on a journey that would take him to the heights of success and beyond. From the humble beginnings of his favela upbringing, he honed his craft with relentless passion and dedication, pouring his heart and soul into every rhyme and verse. As word of his talent spread, Mc Neguinho quickly became a fixture on the local music scene, captivating audiences with his electrifying performances and magnetic stage presence. With each show, he drew closer to his ultimate goal, to make a name for himself in the fiercely competitive world of Brazilian music. But as his star began to rise, so too did the challenges that threatened to derail his journey. The pressures of fame weighed heavily on his shoulders, testing the limits of his endurance and pushing him to the brink of collapse. Yet, amidst the chaos and turmoil, Mc Neguinho remained steadfast in his resolve, refusing to let go of the dreams that had fueled his journey from the very beginning. The price of success. The track and the MC's career follow the line of conscious funk, which since 2020 has renewed the rhythm style in São Paulo with anthems about motorbikes and faith in God, showing the two-wheeled vehicle as a common symbol of overcoming young people who they sing verses about difficult life in the favela. As Mc Neguinho's fame continued to grow, he found himself confronted with a stark reality. The price of success was often higher than he could have ever imagined. The demands of the industry were relentless, pulling him in 1,000 different directions and leaving him with little time to rest or recharge. Caught in the whirlwind of fame and fortune, Mc Neguinho soon found himself grappling with the darker side of his newfound success. The pressures of celebrity took a toll on his mental and emotional well-being, leaving him feeling isolated and alone in a sea of adulation. But perhaps the greatest challenge of all was the constant temptation of excess that surrounded him at every turn. From lavish parties to extravagant indulgences, Mc Neguinho found himself seduced by the trappings of wealth and luxury, losing sight of the values that had once guided him on his journey. The fall from grace. In the dizzying whirlwind of fame and fortune, Mc Neguinho found himself teetering on the edge of a precipice, his footing uncertain and his spirit fragile. The pressures of the industry bore down on him like a weighty burden, each expectation and demand pulling him further away from the essence of who he truly was. Despite the adoration of fans and the trappings of success, an emptiness gnawed at his soul, leaving him feeling hollow and alone in a crowd of admirers. As the days turned into nights and the nights into weeks, Mc Neguinho found himself caught in a downward spiral of self-destructive behavior. The allure of excess beckoned with its seductive whispers, promising escape from the relentless grind of his reality. Parties raged into the early hours of the morning, fueled by a never-ending supply of alcohol and drugs, each indulgence a desperate attempt to fill the void that seemed to grow larger with each passing day. But as the haze of euphoria faded and the harsh light of dawn illuminated the wreckage of his life, McNeguinho was forced to confront the harsh reality of his own mortality. The dreams that had once fueled his ambition now lay shattered at his feet, a cruel reminder of the price he had paid for his fleeting moment in the spotlight. Yet, amidst the chaos and despair, a glimmer of hope still burned within him, a flickering flame that refused to be extinguished. With the support of his loved ones and the unwavering loyalty of his fans, McNeguinho embarked on a journey of self-discovery and redemption, determined to reclaim his rightful place in the world. Mc Neguinho shot dead by police. Mc Neguinho JM, funk singer shot dead by police during chase in SP, dreamed of giving his mother his own house. Security camera video circulating on social media and held by the civil police shows David riding a borrowed motorcycle. In the images, it is possible to see that he was not wearing a helmet and was unarmed when he was shot in the chest and leg by the military police. The funk player did not survive his injuries and died on Rua Marechal Juan Carlos Barreto in Campo Limpo. Jefferson Fernando da Silva Souza, the pillion rider who appears with him on the motorcycle, was also without a helmet and was shot by the agents, but in the head. In the video, you can see the moment he is hit and falls off the motorcycle. He was armed and threatened to shoot at a police base in the neighborhood, according to the PM. According to police, there was an exchange of gunfire. Until the last update of this report, Jefferson remained in a serious condition in a hospital, according to the Public Security Secretariat, SSP. A teenager who was passing through the street at the time of the police chase was also shot in the leg, but her life is not at risk. Shaken by her son's death, Katia is being protected by her family from making statements. The person speaking to the press is her daughter, the clerk Bianca Mireles, 24 years old, sister of Mc Neguinho. The case was initially registered in the 47th Police District, DP, Capão Redondo, as disobedience, bodily injury, and death resulting from intervention against police opposition. As the incident involves military police, the State Department of Homicide and Personal Protection, DHPP, took over the investigations from the civil police. According to the Security Department, a military police inquiry, IPM, was also opened to investigate the conduct of the agents. As we bid farewell to the tumultuous journey of McNeguinho, we're reminded that the path to greatness is often fraught with obstacles and challenges, but through it all, his story serves as a beacon of hope and inspiration for us all. Like, comment, and subscribe to join the movement and spread the message of resilience and redemption. Together, we can rewrite the stars and create a future filled with endless possibilities.